I think this year, as we all feel, there's a consumption slowdown and the outlook remains sketchy. So in this period of turbulence, how does the secondary aluminium industry move forward? To talk about that, we have Mr. Akshay Agarwal, Executive Director of CMR. Can you please share your insights?
Good morning to everyone. Many thanks to MRAI for giving me this opportunity to present to this audience today. The presentation by Kunal was really interesting, but a little bit gloomy, so let me try and cheer you up. The topic for my presentation is going to be aluminium recycling in India, endless opportunities. Before we get into the presentation, I'd like to introduce my company, Century Metal Recycling. We are the largest recycling company in India. Our main product is aluminium alloys, both in the solid and liquid form, and we have a capacity to produce about 300,000 tons of it annually. In the last year, we also diversified into Zurich sorting and electric motor dismantling. In total, we are handling approximately 400,000 tons of non-ferrous scrap annually. Since our inception in 2006, we have been growing at about 30% year on year. We have joint ventures with prominent Japanese and Chinese companies who are at the forefront of the recycling industry globally. And we are proud to be run in a professional manner with a high level of corporate governance. And we continuously strive to become the employer of choice for the recycling industry. So this is how I structured my presentation today. I will start with a general introduction to aluminium, the wonder metal. Next, I will give you some perspective about how the Indian aluminium recycling industry fits in the big global picture. And finally, I will be addressing the opportunities that we currently see shaping the landscape for the industry in the years to come. Aluminium has been the fastest growing non-ferrous metal ever since it was discovered, owing to its favorable strength-to-weight ratio and many other advantages. Aluminium is endlessly recyclable, which is why 90% of aluminium ever produced is still in use today. Recycling of aluminium is also environment-friendly, and compared to primary aluminium, we only consume 5% of the energy and only have 5% of the carbon footprint. As this frees up energy for other applications for the country, aluminium scrap import has actually been equated to importing free electricity into the country by Dr. Agnihotri from JNRDDC, which is the apex aluminium research body for this country. Many countries realize the strategic importance of this metal. China, for example, declared it as one of the 9 pillar industries since 2006. The US and Russia recognize its importance for defense and national security. And many Southeast Asian countries have focused on the aluminum industry as high growth potential industry. Let's move to the next topic, India in perspective. So we are the third largest producer of primary aluminium after China and Russia, but our per capita consumption is only 2.5 kgs compared to the world average of 11 kgs. To be about around the world average for consumption, we need to consume an additional 16 million tons of aluminium over the current 3 odd million tons that we are consuming right now. This highlights the growth potential that the Indian market holds. The Indian scrap industry has been growing at 17 to 18% for the last few years. And right now, we are right around the world average for ratio between primary and secondary. But globally, this ratio is going to change, and the recycled aluminium market share is going to become bigger eventually than the primary share. The import of aluminium scrap has been growing at 15% for the last 5 years, And we currently are at about 1.3 million tons of import. North India is the main market, accounting for about 45% of the total, followed by the South and the West at about 20 to 25% each. Since our consumption of primary metal is lower than production, we also end up exporting about 1.5 million tons of primary metal. Together, the trade balance for the aluminium industry as a whole is positive, so this contributes positively to the foreign exchange reserves of the country. Next up, I will be covering the opportunities for the recycled aluminium market in India. Since CMR's forte is in automotive aluminium, these are the opportunities that I will be focusing on. First, let me give you a sense of the consumption of the automotive aluminium recycling industry today. This is about 760,000 tons as of 2016, and close to about 900,000 tons as of last year, as of 2018. And 81% of this comes from recycling. Further, this 760,000 tons gets divided into rot and unrot, with unrot taking up the lion's share, which is 84%. India has FTAs which are free trade agreements with ASEAN countries like Thailand and Malaysia, which causes the import of this aluminium alloy into the country duty-free. On the other hand, there's a levy of 2.5% duty on aluminium scrap. This implies that the playing field is not level for domestic ingot producers. Let's move on to the opportunities. First opportunity is obviously the growing automotive industry. Currently, India is the fourth largest auto manufacturer. In 2018, India made 5.2 million passenger and commercial vehicles out of the 95 million that were made in the world. As of 2015, the auto and auto comp industry did about 4.6 lakh crores or $65 billion in revenue. Through the AMP, the Automotive Mission Plan 2016 through 26, the target is to reach between 16 and 19 lakh crores or about $265 billion of revenue. This means more than four times in the span of 10 years. The AMP vision is more commonly known as 3-12-65, which is to be the third largest automotive producer next only to China and the US, thus surpassing Japan, to contribute 12% of the GDP from the current 8, and to generate 65 million additional jobs. In order to meet this tall order, the aluminium recycling industry will need to rise to the occasion and go from the current 1 million metric tons of production to 3 million. The automotive mission plan also speaks about end-of-life vehicle recycling policy, which I will address next. In the last 5 to 7 years, the availability of domestically generated scrap has also been growing at 15 to 17%, but we are still only at about 120,000 tons. With the onset of the much-awaited ELV policy, we expect this to really take off. So the ELV recycling policy is expected to incentivize car owners to scrap cars by providing tax breaks on the purchase of new vehicles. We see many large players entering this market in anticipation of the 25 million plus vehicles that are already of age to enter the market as scrap today. For example, the JV between Mahindra and MSTC, Accelo, has been in operation for over a year. Then Maruti and Toyota Tsusho also announced their joint venture, MSTI. However, we expect that the ELV recycling market will be quite different from the rest of the world, where most of the dismantling and recovery will happen by hand, and only the steel shell will probably go to the shredder. Next, as emission norms get tighter, electric vehicles will gain more prominence. As aluminium is lightweight, studies project the use of aluminium in cars growing. For example, a recent European study projected that 20 kgs of aluminium will grow per unit from 180 to 200 kgs. Now it's time to talk about the elephant in the room, or rather the dragon in the room, which is China been reducing their scrap imports. So recent policy flip-flops in China have caused a great deal of uncertainty. Exporters are wary of moving their cargo to China. This has caused closure of many recycling units. And so this large unserviced market in China and markets where China used to export is now a great business opportunity available to Indian manufacturers to export alloys. Data on the right helps compare volume trends between China and India. China has gradually been reducing their scrap imports since 2011. And on the other hand, India has been growing pretty consistently. Now, again, there is going to be a change in July 2020, where scrap is again going to be reclassified as raw material. So whether India can take the place of China as the preferred destination for scrap will still remain to be seen. Next, government of India fully realizes the benefits of recycling, and this is evident from the recent policies that the government has launched to help the aluminium recycling industry. For example, the strategy on resource efficiency that Mr. Satpathy talked about, this is by Niti Aayog. Then the end-of-life vehicle recycling policy by Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, and the aluminium recycling policy by the Ministry of Mines in association with JNRDDC. I'd like to quickly sum up our key takeaways. India's recycled aluminium market holds good promise for fast growth in the near future. Key opportunities include the growing auto industry, growing availability of domestic scrap through the ELV policy, prospect of electric vehicles coming into the main stage for the automotive market, and the slowdown in Chinese import of scrap. And finally, regulatory support from the government is evidence that we realize the strategic importance of aluminium, and this will help this industry a lot. Thank you.